Hello, and today we are with Dagnal Dereveke, who is the acting CEO of Tourism Solomons. Good evening in Solomon Islands, isn't it, Dereveke?
Good evening, Steve.
Now, before we start today's interview, because normally when I do interviews with tourism bodies, everybody knows where I'm talking about them, whether it's Indonesia, Thailand, this, that, the other. I checked into a hotel yesterday and I said to them, "Oh, I'm doing an interview," and I explained I was doing it with the Solomon Islands, and their reaction was, "Where?" So before we get started, because a lot of people don't live in Australia or New Zealand, they don't know Solomon Islands. Where exactly is the Solomon Islands, please?
Hey, thank you, Steve. Solomon Islands is a group of islands just up Papua New Guinea, and just have 3 hours flights from Brisbane in Australia. So it's between Papua New Guinea, Australia, and 1 hour in Fiji in the Pacific Ocean.
With such a remote location, air connectivity is going to, of course, be crucial. What is the situation in terms of air connectivity? Because you can be the best marketeer in the world, but it's not going to matter unless people can get to your islands to enjoy the beauty that there is in Solomon's.
That's correct. Currently, we have direct flights from Brisbane, Australia. Also, a direct flight coming through Port Moresby in Papua New Guinea, and direct flights from Nandi in Fiji. We do not have any long-haul flights directly to the Solomon Islands in the meantime. However, there are plans to look at getting a direct flight from Asia to Honiara. However, there is still a number of work that needs to be done to get that long-haul flight in.
Where in Asia, there you mentioned Asia, where in particular would you like ideally?
In the meantime, the Solomon Island government has signed an air service agreement with China, and there are talks of a direct flight from China to Solomon Islands. Also, there are discussion with Indonesia for an air service agreement, as well as the Philippines. So those are ongoing progress to air service discussions with those two countries as well.
Now, Solomon Islands does have your own national carrier, but it has had a few issues with the aircraft that it has. What is the situation in terms of developing and expanding the national carrier rather than relying on other airlines flying to the country?
Thank you. Currently, Solomon Airlines, our national carrier, operates one A320 and also have about 5 aircraft flying domestic domestic routes, which is the what we call the Dash 8, as well as the twin otter aircraft, which are doing domestic. There are plans to get in an additional A320 airlines to support the current A320 aircraft, because the A320 has come up with some issues, as well as it's there are demand that are coming up, and then they're looking at getting in a new one, or a much newer aircraft, which can be saving this the additional fleets for the Solomon Airlines craft.
What is the status in terms of the airports in Solomon Islands? Are the airports, especially Honiara, is it able to handle larger aircraft if other airlines were to fly in to bring the tourism to the country?
In the meantime, the current Honiara International Airport can only service the smaller A320 aircraft. There are talks of having direct flights from China, which there needs to be an additional meters added onto the current airport. And there are discussions among the Somaliland governments and the Japanese government on extending the airport so that that can accommodate a much bigger airlines into Honiara.
Do you have any time frame for that? What ideally, how quickly could that possibly happen in the next 5, 10 years, or are we looking further afield?
Based on the discussions that I had with the Solomon Islands Airport Corporations Limited, they're looking at a much shorter time frame, which is within the next 5 years. The current progress, current project at the airport was to improve on the overlaying of the current airport, and that will also include the extension of the airport airways, runways as well.
Now, those in Australia and New Zealand have long known about the beauty that can be found in the Solomon Islands. Visitor arrivals are starting to rebound post-COVID. What is the current situation in terms of tourism into the country?
Yes, the Solomon Islands has enjoyed a steady growth of 7% annually over the years until 2019. And then we have this COVID, which really impacts on the visitors' arrival. We reopened borders on 1st of July 2022. Since then, we've seen numbers slowly climbing back to pre-COVID levels. However, as of this first quarter, although we have received about 3,000 numbers, it's still later below the pre-COVID level for 2019. However, it has surpassed the first quarter of 2020 level. So we're looking at a steady growth coming out of COVID.
What are your targets for this year and also for next year as we move forward?
A major market is Australia and New Zealand. All throughout, we've seen growth from these two markets. We are coming out of COVID more focused on the short-haul market, Australia, New Zealand, and the Pacific Island countries. Slowly, we are moving out again to the long-haul markets, like the North American market, as well as the Asian market. By 2024, we are looking at going back to the long-haul market, which is North America and the Asian market.
In terms of demographics of guests, when you expand further afield to the North American markets and hopefully to China, Indonesia, Philippines, as you've already mentioned, how will the demographics of your guests and the length of stay change?
Is our usual source market, which is Australia, New Zealand, and North America, we are more familiar with that. China is a new market for us since the political switch in 2019. We still haven't entered China as yet. However, there are groundworks in place that we will explore more of the Chinese market. We still really yet to understand the Chinese market and so forth. However, our destination mainly offers the more of an adventure niche-based sorts of market. And that's where we are looking at getting visitors from the Asian market that are more adventurous and that we would like to explore and experience the natural environment that we have.
How has Solomon Islands changed its immigration policies? Because, of course, travel has changed a lot since pre-COVID. These days, there's digital nomads that people are able to work remotely, and you don't get much more remote than the Solomon Islands. How have you changed your immigration policies to enable a different type of traveler to come and stay for extended periods in the country?
Yes, with regards to the immigration law, the Immigration Department under the Minister of Commerce now are working on a revised immigration bill. The consultations has been carried out. We are hoping that the revised immigration bill, which will be put through Parliament, will give more access and be more flexible in getting visitors into the country. However, at the same time, maintain the protection of the country against unwanted issues that the immigration law is protecting on.
Of course, MICE meetings and incentive conventions and exhibitions and what have you, this is a very important thing. And very soon you will be hosting the Pacific Games later this year. How important is that to the country? And what do you want people to take from the hosting of this? What is the goal?
Is the hosting of the Pacific Games for Solomon Islands is quite a significant event for us. It's the first time that Solomon Islands will be hosting the Games, and it will be one of the biggest events that we will ever hosted. For tourism, we will be expecting to see more visitors, especially the athletics from the other countries coming into Solomon Islands. For us, this is an opportunity for us to showcase our cultures, at the same time, showcase Solomon Islands to those athletes and also visitors who will be coming to visit us. And this may give them the memories that they will take back to their countries and tell others that Solomon Islands is the place to visit, is the friendliness of Solomon Islands and so forth by word of mouth.
What is your schedule in terms of the build-up to the games, in terms of media coverage, then during the games, but most importantly, after the games have finished? A lot of the times, like the Tour de France, everybody watches the Tour de France, thinks, wow, what a beautiful country, I want to go there. And then they don't hear anything about it until the next time that the Tour de France is on. How are you going to maintain the momentum of people looking and seeing the Solomon Islands?
Currently, we are working closely with the Games Organizing Committee and moving towards the opening of the Games. We have engaged with them in trying to go along with the baton relay, which will be an event that is leading to the game. Also, we are working closely with them in engaging with the international media that will be coming, so that we will try and get slots to promote Solomon Islands to their audience during the games. After the games, that's quite a challenging question. For the Solomon Islands government, we are looking at sports tourism as an avenue of maintaining momentum with the games facilities that we have, and also in exchange of visitors through sporting and so forth.
All of these athletes, the tourists, all of these tourists from around the world that are going to want to come to Solomon Islands, of course, have to stay somewhere. How many hotel rooms does the Solomon Islands currently have, and what is the development pipeline like in the Solomon Islands?
Is the accommodation is it will be a challenge for us, having this influx of visitors for that short term. Currently, we have about 8 hotels in Honiara, and there are about 501 hotel rooms that are currently available. We have been working closely with the Games Organizing Committee to also explore other accommodations that maybe not hotels, but that can accommodate visitors during the games as well.
Are you getting companies approaching you looking to invest in property in Solomon Islands to develop more hotels?
Yes, currently there is a program that the government is working closely with the International Finance Corporation, as well as the Minimum Challenge Corporation, on what we call the accessing land and for tourism investment. This is to identify investable sites that can be promoted to investors when they are interested in, if they're interested, then they can come and do investment in Solomon Islands in building hotels and so forth.
Of course, travel trade shows are very important, especially for small places, remote areas such as Solomon Islands. Which travel trade shows will Solomon Islands be attending over the next 12 months to promote the country?
There are a couple of trade shows that we usually attend, the common one being the South Pacific Tourism Exchange. Also, we used to attend the Dimas show in the North America for dive show. Also, we usually attend the ITB Asia, as well as the ITB Berlin. And we have a local exchange, which we call the Miss Service Solo, which we will be hosting in October this year as well. So those are some of the tourism exchanges that we usually attend.
Of course, we've talked very vaguely about the beauty and the wonders that are available to be seen and experienced in Solomon Islands. But if somebody was looking at somewhere like Fiji, Tonga, Samoa, Reunion, even Maldives and Mauritius, which are a bit further away, why should they choose Solomon Islands as somewhere to visit?
Yeah, I think Solomon Islands is quite unique on its own. We have our neighbors who also share similar features to Solomon Islands. However, for us, we pride ourselves with our people and our culture. And also, we are more of an adventure niche market, which we have experienced that are more unique and not that I would say developed, however, more at community and more sustainable sorts of products that we have. It's not that to develop, but it's just the natural offering that we have.
And finally, this question, in terms of the market, in terms of cruise market, because we have covered the air market, but is the cruise market, how important is that to you?
Is a cruise market is also slowly a growing market for Solomon Islands, especially the expedition cruises. That's quite important for us as they actually go out to the islands in the provinces and actually engage with the communities, and that's where the cruise money actually is going down to the community compared to the bigger cruise, which only comes to Honiara and Gizo on a day, like maybe a day. But the expedition cruise, they actually spend a couple of days going from islands to islands, so they actually engage with the communities.
They sound like a lot of fun, I must say. Well, Danielle, I'd love to keep asking you millions of questions because there's so much to cover and so much to, as there is to experience, I'd imagine, in the country. But I have to say thank you very much indeed for your time today. And of course, I wish you and everyone in Solomon Islands the best of luck for the future. Thank you.
Thank you very much, Steve, for talking with me. Thank you.